Hello and welcome to Loving Tech Life. I'm going to show you how to connect your PS5 controller to your PC with DS4Windows for the most compatibility with games. Let's get into it. To begin with, you're going to download the three files you need for the setup. I'll leave links below in the description to all of them. The first is DS4Windows itself. Just do a search for DS4Windows and ignore the top result. And scroll down to the official GitHub resource from Ryo-chan. Here, you'll find what might be the final release version of this software from January 1st this year, as of the time of making this video. Scroll down and click on either one of the x64 zip files. Note that you'll need a tool like 7-zip or similar to unzip this later. I'll leave a link to 7-zip in the description in case you don't have it already. Second, we're going to download the .NET 8 runtime that DS4 needs to install and work properly. You can search for this yourself, but Ryo-chan has put a link to it here in the GitHub. I'm saving this to the same folder as DS4Windows, so it's easy to find later. Lastly, we need to download the VisionBus driver, so search for VisionBus, click on the GitHub link, and scroll down and download the VisionBus EXE. Again, I'm putting it in the same folder as the rest. Now that I have all the files downloaded, we can get started with installing everything. First, open the folder with all your files. I just put them into the downloads folder on my PC. We're going to install the .NET 8 runtime first by double-clicking this file. Then install. If Windows pops up with a warning, go ahead and accept it. These .NET runtimes are all above board. Next, we'll install the VisionBus driver that we downloaded, as it's the latest version available. Just double-click the VisionBus file, click Next on the installer, then agree to the terms and conditions, and again, accept the Windows pop-up if it appears for you, and it will install. Now we're ready to set up DS4Windows. Begin by right-clicking the zip or 7-zip folder and select Extract All. I'm extracting it to the same folder I'm in right now, so it's easy to work with. Open the DS4Windows folder that pops up, and in here you're looking for the DS4Windows.exe, which has a colorful icon like this right next to it. Double-click on it, and here I recommend selecting the Program folder option on the left. The Enabled Devices Mapper Support window pops up. And here, depending on the controller you're using with DS4Windows, you tick the box next to it. To avoid conflicts and problems later, don't tick all of the boxes for all of the controllers. If you have already installed DS4Windows before watching this guide, don't worry, I'll show you how to find it on DS4Windows itself in a little bit. Since we're setting up DS4Windows for my PS5 controller, we'll untick the DS4 Device Support and tick the box here next to DualSense Device Support, and then select Close at the bottom. After this, the DS4Windows app pops up. Now you can connect your PS5 controller to the computer with a cable or Bluetooth. To start, I connected the controller with a USB cable, and you should see it appear here on DS4Windows. If you want to connect the controller wirelessly with Bluetooth, I'll leave a card at the top with a link to a video on how to get it connected. The main thing here is to have Bluetooth on your PC. If you don't have it, I'll leave a link to a Bluetooth USB adapter I use in the description below. By default, DS4Windows is making your PC think you have connected an Xbox 360 controller for the most compatibility with games. A downside to this is that in games you'll see the Xbox button prompts instead of the PlayStation X, square, circle, and triangle buttons. A common question I get is how you get the PlayStation buttons to show up in game. Unfortunately, unless the game actually supports the PlayStation controller, the PlayStation buttons won't show up in game. However, there is a way for DS4Windows to enable the PlayStation buttons in games that support it. You do this by clicking the Edit button here, going to the tab here called Other, and selecting the drop-down next to Emulated Controller. Instead of the default Xbox 360 controller, select DualShock 4 and click Save. You can now try the game you want and see if the PlayStation controller buttons appear in-game and if the controller works for you. If it's not compatible, you can switch it back to emulate an Xbox 360 controller by going back into the Other tab, selecting Xbox 360 in the drop-down and selecting Save again. Note that every time you want to use DS4Windows, you need to have it open and select Start on the bottom right. You will need to keep the DS4Windows app open while you're using it. I mentioned before that I'd show you how to find the Enable Devices Mapper Support window that popped up at the beginning in case you want to go back and add or remove other controller support. To do this, just select the Settings tab at the top, then select Device Option button here on the right-hand side. This will pop up the same window that we had before when we launched DS4Windows. If you're having issues with connecting your controller, then check out the Controller Fix playlist on the card above. I'll also put a link to the playlist in the description below. I'll keep adding other controller fixes to the playlist, so be sure to subscribe for more. Thank you for watching, and if this video helped you out, please go ahead and smash the like button below, and I'll see you in the next one.